2 clicks, way too complex. I wanted 1 click. So that's what I did. Bonjour, hi, welcome to this new episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you how you can give the power to your user to deploy whatever he wants using nested ARM template and conditions. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. Most solutions contain multiple parts, and all of those parts have their own deployment cycle and life circles. And sometimes we want to deploy just the back end, and sometimes just the front end, and sometimes we want everything to be deployed at once. So that means we need multiple deployment structure, and it's painful. So what I want to show you today is how you could write the code once to deploy and give the liberty to the person who's deploying to pick whatever it wants, and everything will be fine. Interested? Let me show you. So in this project, AZ URL Shortener, it's a your open source project that I have on GitHub, so all links will be in the description to the documentation, to the GitHub repo, and way more. So have a look in the description. In this project, what I did is I was really looking forward to make something simple where the user could deploy everything that it wants. So this use a backend that use Azure function, and the frontend right now only have one. It's a web app that I did in Blazor. But you could run headless without any frontend, and you're just calling it from Postman or any tool you have. Or you could build your own tool in whatever Python or JavaScript and call my APIs. That's whatever you want. So I want to give the choice to the person to deploy just what it needs, but I want to make it simple. Right now, it was, yes, you could deploy the backend, one click, you wait, and then the second, the front end, click, and then you're done. 2 clicks, way too complex. I wanted 1 click. So that's what I did. So if you click, it will open the Azure portal. And now it will just go here, and I added a parameter called frontend. And in this parameter, let me just first select it, and then I will zoom. So in here, what it does, it gives you the option. You could pick one, or you could pick the front end you want. In your case, it could be anything you want. Like it could be, okay, I want this package, blah, blah, blah. You decide what you want. With that, of course, you will need to pass more parameters since you're deploying multiple source. You need to cover all those entries, those inputs. So you have more inputs to, you know, send at the beginning. I want to show you how I did that using nested ARM template and some condition. You will see it's very easy. So let's go in the ARM template. So this is my ARM template. I have 2 ARM templates. So one for the back end, one for the front end, like I said, and both will still be able to work independently. So what I want to do now is add this new parameter that we need that will switch our condition. So let's go here and I will just add it quickly. I will explain. So my parameter is frontend. You name it the way you want. Now the strategy here is to allow only some values. And that's really important. That's why you have the list or the drop-down menu in the portal. And that way you will be able to put some condition and you know the expected value. So it will be much easier that way. In my case, again, none and website. It's a good idea, good best practices to put a default value because everybody likes next, 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 next when they deploy. And also put a description because it may be clear for you what you intend to do with that. But good guess is it's not that clear for the end user. So put as much clear instruction as you can. I will need to add the extra new parameter. So let's just add that quickly. Voila. So I needed an admin email and a password for my interface. Perfect. So now I have all the input that I need. The others, maybe I already have the value. Maybe I will generate that when I'm deploying. For example, in my case, the front end required the URL from the Azure function. That's not a problem, I could retrieve that, and I will show you how I did it. So now what we want is to add this nested deployment. So we'll go here, and we'll go straight at the end of our ARM template, and we'll add a new resource. This resource will be of type Microsoft Resource Deployments. Exactly, right? You want to do another deployment inside the first deployment. So, you know, it's kind of inception here. An important point is the depends on. So make sure, like your second deployment, if it has any dependency, that those dependency are done deploying. In my case, it was really important that not only the function app was deployed, but my function were defined. So I needed the synchronization between GitHub in my case and the Git inside app service was done. So I needed to also add this source control in my dependency. Then resource group, API version, we're used to that. Mode could be new for you. So like the deployment mode is really interesting, very powerful. Right now it's using incremental. That means when you're deploying stuff, it won't touch any resources that are not specified in this ARM template. If you are changing the resource that's the same name or something, then it will hack. Otherwise, it doesn't care. And it's also very powerful because if you're deploying in mode complete an empty ARM template, you could delete all the resources inside your resource group without losing your resource group. So that's pretty clever when you're trying to clean up without losing the security and all the setting you did on your resource template. But that's another video. The second, let's clean that a little bit. Voila, boom. So here, template link and kind of the main course of this activity. So what we do here is extract the URL from a variables, and I will show you that variables in 2 seconds. But the template links, what's important is to understand it needs to be a URL or a URI. It cannot be a local file. This way, you will be able to reach out, and if they have security, you could add a token. You will be able to get your second template and deploy it. You could also use the inline. So if you're injecting full object, you could have inline code there. But I prefer working with ARM template in a file, so both deployment can be individual if I want. Let me show you the variables. So I will jump on the top of my screen in the variable. So front end just here. So what I did, I created a variable called front end info, and it will be a kind of an array of different objects. So right now I only have one object, and it's the admin Blazor website that match the variable I have on the top. So this way, that's how I can do A. Inside this, take the object name admin Blazor website and give me the parameter or the value of the member ARM template URL. So if I had multiple object, I could do that. So you could have an object and then use that dynamically. So see again, that's the main object, the main variable name, it's called frontend info. I want to go get the object with this name, matching the value of the frontend parameter, and we'll get the value of ARM template. So let's go again in the ARM template to see the value. So see here, I'm extracting the frontend info variable, getting, like it's between square bracket here, getting the value of the parameter frontend. So get me the object, and from that object, so now I have like the object, I can go then pick up the property ARM template URL, and that's how it works. And then we have the parameter. So, you know, you pass the parameter that you already have in here, or here I'll just concatenate a new value to my base name, just to, you know, make sure the name have some kind of link connection, but they are not the same. For the function URL, that's a little bit more complex. Let's go through it. I will explain what I did. So I'm concatenating the URL. And for me, that was really important because my front end will call those APIs, those function, and I need to know exactly the URL with the security code because my functions are protected. So that's what I did. So let me switch. I have a little code snippet. Will be easier that way. I'm concatenating four information. So the first one, HTTPS, that's kind of a classic. And now I'm building that reference. So I'm referencing my website and I'm getting the host name. The host names are an array. Right now, what I'm doing is I'm extracting the blah, 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 azurewebsite.net domain name. So I need that. That could be cool as a URL for the function app, but I want a specific function. In this case, I was really looking for the URL list. That's the function I want to call. And I'm already starting my query string to retrieve the value of the variable code. And that's for me, the security key or the token that is built in Azure. That will be done using the new function inside ARM template called list keys. And again, I will be concatenating, like getting information from function app. And let's zoom again for the end of the information. I will go then check in the host default, extracting the function key default. And that will be my security token that I need. With all that together, now I have my complete function URL and I will be able to pass that to my deployment. So inside my config or whatever, I will have those URL and then my frontend will be able to call my backend. So cool. So now we have all the template, but now you may tell yourself, Frank, now it will be deploying all the time. There's no condition here. You're right. And let's fix that. So what I want to do here is I will add a condition. So to do that, so here I do a condition. So very simple here. It's a function of ARM template. So I use that. And you know, when it's not equal to none, when the front end is not equal to none, then it will be executed. Otherwise, it will just the full resources will be ignored. So very useful. So of course, the condition could be simpler, more complex, it depends on you. I know it's a lot of information in one shot, very condensed in an ARM template. It might be difficult to see on your screen. So that's why I put inside GitHub a folder named tuto, and inside of it, you will have a before after subfolder with the two ARM templates. So this way you could compare and see the difference and understand by yourself. But you will see at the end, it's very simple. I added a parameter, I added a deployment resource, and the magic was done. So I hope this video was useful for you. If you have questions, don't hesitate to write it down in the comments or come see me on Twitch. So at twitch.tv/fbucheros, I stream live coding twice a week and you can ask me their question. And that's when we work on project like this Azure URL shortener. So don't forget, subscribe, click the bell icon, all those things, leave a comment. It's always very appreciated. And I will see you next time. Thanks.